Back up to Bell.
This
Bell's
guy needs
three
to get
for
going.
Three here in the second. Oh, my goodness. This afternoon with positive energy for the Red Storm. Bell for three. Bell hits it.
Oh, my goodness.
Troy Bell, 52-51, St. John's. Troy Bell with... Here's Bell.
Glover on Bell.
Oh, he wastes him. Baseline spinner. Got it, and the foul. Troy Bell. Troy Bell having a fabulous second half. He's got 23 points, 19 here in the second half.
The second leading scorer in the Big East Conference, a freshman. The switching helped, but Glover out of his element at the three-point line defending a little guy. And Bell has an extremely quick first step. Woo! Check that out. Nice spin move. This guy can play.
Bell, 3 of 5. Ball. Singletary's got it. BC's Bell. Got a life.
Bell's
got
to shoot this one.
Bell, they get a pick. Shoots a three. It's good. Troy Bell ties it at 58.
Time left to go. 4.8. That last three that Bell took about a second and a half for him to get the ball up the floor. Nice screen right here. Everybody with their hand up. Nothing but bottom for Bell.
He could bring it from all ends of the floor, and he's leading the team in scoring. He's the team's top three-point shooter. He can really fill it up if you don't get out there after him. He's also got great quickness and leaping ability.
And Lockhart takes it all the way, rejected by Bell.
He can get up too.
Rear and Holmes check back in.
Lockhart thinks he's in good shape once he goes by Brian Ross, but enter Troy Bell into the
year. When you look at his numbers from a year ago where he played so well, he's scoring better, he's shooting it better, and he's dishing the ball to his teammates much more effectively. Clearly the go-to guy for the Eagles.
Meanwhile, for
ultimate drive of the game, you know, there's quick and then there is lightning hot quick. And that's Troy Bell. Look at that feed.
Yeah, nice pass to Ross inside.
The wraparound feed, here's another look.
He's just so fast. He turns the corner. If you give help, he's going to find guys. He does so there.
And shuts him off.
He's not allowing penetration. Doing a good job.
A dish to Bierbaum. Beautifully done by Troy Bell.
All five of St. John's field goals early came on the paint.
Michael Cotton playing so well early in traffic. Sees Bell out there with that over-the-shoulder look. And he is really...
He's done a good job of rebounding thus far on the defensive board. Here's Troy Bell, nifty crossover, laying it up and in!
Oh, what a nip that time up!
7 already.
Check out this move by the freshman. Now trying to force him left is Barkley, but check out the shift. He goes right there. Just that quick move right by the defense. Finishes.
Troy Bell today, he had 28 against Michigan, 29 in a loss to UMass, and he's BC's high score today with 17.
And when he's been most effective, it's been in the open floor situations where he gets, as I said, a running start. He gets a chance to dart to his...
Bell again, wide open for three.
Aaron Maxey fell under the same spell that Singletary fell under a few moments ago. Take a look at the shot there. Again, better in quickness, better in a flowing type of offense is Troy Bell.
Getting up. Chudney Gray making his move, handing to Jesse. Stolen by Bell ahead of the field. He'll slam it down.
The players that do play on this team, you know, it's not like they're out there looking over their shoulder. They know they're going to get a lot.
Got to throw it over the top of them. We'll be back in a moment with Boston College trailing by 3. You're watching Big East Basketball from ESPN Plus.
They did a nice job there to regroup with the basketball.
Long range three, Troy Bell!
Said previously close to Northeastern.
This is Bell, the turnaround three!
Oh, on the dime! He can fire it, he can feel it tonight, Troy!
Front court. This is Bell, look at that three! Oh, my!
NBA three! That one had to be from 25 plus. He feels it tonight.
Ron, how do you defend that? I mean, most kids aren't coached to go that far up. Bell the other way. Bell spinning, scoring, he has 20.
Beautiful move, he's getting to a low. Bell right now is gonna take charge and show some leadership for BC.
The shot that Shannon Brooks put up. Bell open, Bell scores! He's equal to career high, 32.
Ryan C. Sidney pushing it, getting it to Bell. Great pass, the crowd involved. BC seems to be answering the bell right now, but UMass has been really pushing them here in the second half.
Well, they love it in Chestnut Hill.
Some wild hairdos here tonight. Check out Sidney, though. Find the shooter out there, and it's definitely Bell. Make good decisions with the ball. Give a lot of credit to Sidney. And how about Bell? He doesn't show you a lot of emotion out there, but he's pretty pumped up as well when he drops that one in.
He's equal to
his characteristic, what we're showing you here. Troy Bell, fast hands, steals the basketball, goes down, gets an easy layup. This next one we show you is not a instant replay. This time a different kind of turnover, and Bell, same result, two easy points.
Seven times, you're exactly right. There's another steal. Here comes Bell, and he dunks it.
It is the story of the basketball game right now, because every time these guys come out, trap, you know, you've got three guys involved there. Sidney comes up with it and kicks it to Bell, and he takes it right to the basket.
Drive of the game. This guy's been driving the boat all night long. See ya.
I'll tell you what, he takes it and gives a little crossover dribble, puts it in his right hand, and then gets inside amongst the big guys and still lays it off the glass. He is a player that plays under.
The hand is almost in his jersey.
Well, you know what he's doing. He's doing a nice job of following him.
He got hit. Count it.
That's the one area that John Linehan will have difficulty with Troy Bell. Troy Bell at 6'1", Linehan at 5'9". Bell's got the reach. If he can find some daylight, as he did here, he might make some shots. You see on the reverse right there, able to shoot over Linehan. Nothing much John Linehan can do. Again, quick move by Bell. No hesitation. It's when you hesitate on guys like John Linehan that you're lost.
No.
Nope. Play on the part of Boston College. We saw Maxey's basket, and here's the steal right there in transition. Boston College forces about 20 turnovers per game, and they have 10 steals per game, which allows them to get easy opportunities people in this building right now. No longer is this the Conte board.
That's right. How about Bell? He beat Lennon, and a good one here. Conte for him, 7:27 to go. First half. Troy Bell looking good.
Over for him.
Boy, Shabazz, a presence of mind to just get over. Steal. Bell went by the official for the jam. Defense is mixed now. Talk about being conscious of where the defense is. Bell way over the top for three.
There is no defense for that. For him, he would have liked to have gotten his feet set. And look at Bell stepping back. Said, play this.
Yeah.
We talked about Troy Bell in this last 4 minutes. Expect him to see a lot more picks at the top to get him off. And he's a creator. He creates for himself as well as others.
Tariq by Tariq Brown, his 21st steal of the year. Oh! Nice dish here by Tariq Brown. It looks like he catches the trailer. Albert Mooring coming down the lane, but nice strip by, I think it was Troy Bell, setting up the to get the wins and say, hey, we believe in ourselves is huge, particularly early.
Troy Bell with the pull-up jumper. He has Selby right and Tariq Brown left. Look at the play by Troy Bell. Oh!
And a windmill type of block by Troy Bell, as you can see Caron Butler again with that nifty move, but it was good play.
See, Tariq Brown leads with three fouls. Bell with the acrobatic drive over Robertson. 1 point Boston College lead. Troy Bell leading the way. You're watching Big East basketball from Bell. Just personifies quickness.
Really does. How about the way he regrouped there, Bob, after he deflected to come up with that ball? Great balance.
His position as the two guard. Bell penetrates, kick out Singletary. Xavier Singletary with his
NCAA tournament. We're going to see one of the best players in the nation, the freshman of the year in the conference, perhaps nationally. Shot block leader Eddie Griffin for Seton Hall. Troy Bell, co-player of the year for Boston College. Eagles and Pirates, we start next. Run. Troy Bell and company were very convincing in their 83-79 win over Villanova in the first quarter. Barrett tried to push, lost it. But Speedy Bell, contact with Lane, and it's going to make a three-point play opportunity.
But when you look at Troy Bell, you take a look at his body makeup. He was a little skinny kid last year. Got in a weight room, gained a few pounds, some muscle, and he's able to take those types of bumps and still finish, whereas last year he couldn't. Right there, once again, he initiates the contact, essentially. But with that upper body strength, able to finish, and that's one of the things that's made him such a good player. But this particular, that's the one thing that has really helped him over the last couple of games.
Troy Bell. The conventional three-point play, and now the three. These two teams didn't play in the regular season, a tight game. Conference Co Player of the Year, Troy Bell. Chance on the big stage to show his stuff. So the people you're around, you get comfortable with. But Troy Bell's had a wonderful season to help Al Skinner's situation.
Well, you saw the daylight right there, and Dalembert gets in, and look at him trying to help Troy Bell up. Think they're listening to the same thing?
I think they're listening to you, Len. Bell on the drive. At the same time.
Troy Bell running the break right here. This is where Boston College is at its best, with Bell at the point of transition. And when you have finishers like Ryan Sidney, no-nonsense guy, you're in great shape.
BC has scored 21 of the last 24.
Well, absolutely, again, Boston College very opportunistic. It began with their defense. And once they get a chance to get out in transition.
He is Troy Bell, a co-MVP in the Big East Conference this year. It's a close game all of a sudden. The second half, he made a huge run. What was the key to that, Troy?
I don't know. We were just excited out there. I mean, we were playing on emotion. I mean, a lot of people say we couldn't be here, and we're just happy to be in this position.
You hadn't met Seton Hall all year. You knew they'd be tough with Samuel Dalembert and Eddie Griffin inside, and the way Barrett handles the ball outside. Why'd you have such an easy time with them in the second half?
They have good shot blockers, but they don't slide on defense, and we knew that. We watched them play all year. I mean, they're a good team, and they're going to be a lot better next year, but this year we're the better team.
Troy, who's going to survive this tournament this year?
I don't know. Hopefully we will.
Thanks a lot. Best of luck to you.
All right, thank you.
Mike.
Bell driving, spinning, and winning.
That is an unbelievably tough shot. See where they got in trouble.
Troy Bell. Again! There's the Big East Conference Co-Player of the Year.
Troy Bell gets the opportunity to make this play because they got the ball back on an offensive rebound, but Bell just... Troy Bell picking up that fourth personal foul, but he beats the defense. Monaco goes for the steal. Now here's Bell. This is a risky play with four personal fouls, but he's able to get the... Troy Bell struggled in the first half, 0 for 5 from the field, but he has made up for it in the second half, scoring with three-point shots, great moves to the basket, losing the defense on the dribble, and then getting out on the fast break. Bell, who had 2 points at halftime, now has 50.
1 more look. Bell. Bell pulls up. Count it. And the foul.
What a big time play Troy Bell makes right here. You just sense this game getting away a little bit. Bell freezes Granville with that dribble, and then Granville commits the foul. Hands of Troy Bell getting things set. 15 left on the shot clock.
Here's Bell, low dribble. Shake and bake to the bucket, double clutch.
Oh!
And the Boston College Eagles have taken the lead. Bell takes a three. And hits! Troy Bell with 9.7 to go. Timeout, Boston College.
Troy Bell just rises up. This time a nice on-balance shot. He's not forced to a double clutch in the air. Just nails it.
Now take a look at the numbers. It backs up everything that Al Skinner said. I mean, Sidney, what's impressive, that bottom number, 10 rebounds a game. Now that's Oscar Robertson-type average there, 20 points, 10 rebounds.
Yeah, he's fearless. He'll go to the glass. He'll find people. He is a fearless basketball.
Straight coming into this one where he has scored at least 20 points. There's Bell. Pulls up, and he fouled again and makes it.
By Sullivan.
Jake Sullivan twice. And now keep in mind, folks, this is a guy that's familiar with Troy Bell because he played against him in summer leagues and AAU ball. And if anybody knows his game, it would be Jake Sullivan.
Well, I'm not so sure. He's just too anxious to get at the shot. I mean, he's trying to challenge it. But from there, you cannot foul a jump shooter. And this is a deep jump shot. You see Sullivan come after it. No doubt about the foul. When you come across from the either side, Pearson just gets right in the lane. That's a play too. Troy Bell single up for three. Now Pearson just really punches in the leg.
11 is in the ball game, and really the only point guard that was recruited by Iowa State. As Troy Bell runs that play again, Quinn.
It's not a play. It's just Troy at the top, right?
Well, you've got to respect his outside shot for obvious reasons. But if you challenge him, this is what Troy Bell can do to you as well. Boston College back in front. It's been interesting. Troy Bell, what kind of a half has he had so far? That's a pretty good game for most guys. 21 points on 7 of 7 free throw shooting, 5 of 8 from the floor, 4 of 5 from behind the arc.
Perfect 8-0. And they're moving up in the polls, but this is a different team than Al Skinner had last year. They rely more on their guards, Ryan Sidney and Troy Bell. In the first half, Troy Bell really carried that team, scoring 21 points. If Iowa State wants to get into this game where they can win on the road, they've got to keep pounding the ball inside to Tyree Pearson. That's where they've had success, and they've also got to keep Troy Bell off the free throw line. When you foul him, he is automatic from that line. Nobody gets to the line more often than he does.
Bell, the 20. 25 in the second half, the 30-8 UMass run. Bell goes all the way, lays it in. He turned the corner on Shane Power. There was no help side defense at all.
That is poor recognition defensively.
Bell looked out, and I thought he was going to pull right up, but he wanted the defense to think that as well. Drew the contact and pulled back and banked it in.
Yeah, we'll see. They're getting a little bit momentum.
30 points for Bell.
Troy Bell. Here, Powers is up on him close and just kind of heads and shoulders goes by. No help. Troy Bell easily to the basket on that side. And then he comes to the other side. Other side takes the hit, knocks it off the glass. And it was interesting when they played Morris Brown, when Boston College played Morris Brown, they were playing in the game. And Ryan had to say something to Bell because he didn't come with his mind focused and ready to play. So it's kind of interesting, you know, that you need to be juiced up or jazzed, if you will, to come and play a game.
Yeah.
But that's been the case.
Look at the numbers. Last two games with still some work to be done here tonight with 8.5 on the clock. 16 of 28 from the floor.
They complement each other well. They really don't get in each other's way. They play very differently. And one obviously has the ball, and another one doesn't need it in order to be successful. So I don't know if they are the best backcourt, but I do know they complement each other extremely well, and that allows them to be very successful.
Yeah, it is interesting when you block them.
Bell goes right in to the teeth of the defense and draws the foul and makes a difficult floater. 32 points now for Troy Bell.
Shot, dang. Really tough. I mean, you talked about how high he jumps. The other thing to take into consideration when he gets himself into position is how quickly he jumps. I mean, he got it up and toward the basket before any of the help.
That was off the back iron. Sidney with a rebound. Nice look underneath. Quick to the Bell, who lays it in. That's a new career high for Troy Bell.
I'm telling you, Sidney is some kind of boy. That's a pass. He makes a pretty. Bell gets big numbers. But the compliment of Sidney is excellent for this team. Long rebound, it'll go left. Now watch Sidney get it. Right away, see the open man. And I mean, he gets it there quickly.
Fourth foul against Sullivan. Bell 11 for 11 from the free throw line. 36 long pass.
He got it. Same thing. Same play.
Same play to Bell. And he's grabbed there by Pearson.
It's a tough situation when you've got everybody on the front side of half court. That's what they did. Bell looked like he was going to set a screen and just took off. And then Pearson comes over and fouls him. Well. Boy, Bell giving up big numbers, boy. At 40, looking 41. It's hard to get it much better than that. I'm sorry, Dave. I mean, you can see a little bit of pre-celebration, if you will, here by Agbay. Troy, you don't get another shot.
He's used to get fouled from behind the arc.
He's used to getting three shots. He didn't want to come off the line. You get two in the ball is what you get for intentional.
Down last couple of years, BC is 80-0 when they get the transition game going. Agbaye nearly picked up number two on that steal. Troy Bell, he is just getting after it early. He's got two of the first three hoops for BC. And this is defense creating good offense, prompting Providence to call timeout to see if they can settle now. Nice strip.
Sure was. Feeding frenzy. Bell ahead of the pack. Gets the jam.
You know, in the old days, the guards used to just go in and lay those in off the glass. Forget about it now. Two-hand stuff.
5-point lead. Bell over the top. He hits.
Well, that's not an easy one. That's a three for Bell. He's having a dynamite first half. And that means he was very active. Mills there stripped. He had an excellent first half for Providence, but that one was a Sydney to Bell stuff as they got it done. And Bell was the man for Boston College. He was very focused in the first half.
In the corner, here's Bell. Baseline jumper, he hits. That's a three. Troy Bell with 21 now. He's 4 out of 5 from the...
I think Mills caught him on the arm. Nice look by Sidney. He does a good job to find Bell, and that's what Bell needs. Got to get the ball to him. It's really not a matchup. They're just quick with it with Linehan up top.
Got some air on that one, didn't he? Troy Bell! Big three!
And Mills is having a great shooting night, only to be matched by Troy Bell, who has been just on fire. 9 for 13 from the floor in this game. He's shooting 69%, and the rest of the team, Dave, has been much cooler here tonight.
Rest of the team shooting 10 for 27. Bell having the outstanding. They get it to Bell, wide open. He makes him pay.
Wow. He is on tonight. Check it out. Making the threes, making the...
Bell's open again. He'll fire from in front of the bench. Count
it! Oh, he's just on fire.
Troy Bell with 30. And we've got 13:50 to go.
Got the crowd involved as well.
A career high, 7 threes for Troy Bell. In college now in charge, and one thing Providence has got to do, they've got to find number two.
Well, I mean, the way things are going, I mean, you've got the 2-3 for Providence. Bell is just sticking it. He's been the man. You may find Tim Welch with this hot, hot hand for Bell. He's knocking those threes down now like nothing. You may see some man-to-man out of this timeout with pressure on Bell. He's just on fire.
Fourth 30-point game for Bell this season. Leading score, Sidney on the bench with 4 fouls. Ross, a little too deep. Lacks it, and stolen by Bell. Bell goes up, and he lays it up. He beat Linehan, who couldn't afford to foul him. Linehan playing with 3 fouls. It's 76-71 Boston College. Before Joe Lindsay got it, his attention was drawn to Tim Welch.
Bell just took that ball away on the weak side, didn't he?
Yeah, out-muscled him.
Check it out. Ball just catches iron, and he just takes it from Laxa. It finishes it. Big basket. Bell has been...
Get that ball out of his hands.
He's got 6. Deep three. Bell, plenty of range. My goodness. Troy Bell with 14. His second three tonight.
We'll start hitting those shots, Dave, and where BC really becomes effective. I remember going there 20-plus years ago. It was tough.
Bell again, he gave him room, and he's killing Villanova. 35-30, 17 for Bell. Bell's very quick, a change of direction, going hard left, and all of a sudden square up and
turnovers. Need a team there really showing that they want to win this game.
Reverse layup on the pump by Troy Bell. 21 points for Troy.
Just a little seam, that's all he needs. And I like the fact that these road teams are fighting back.
Quick release! Oh, what a great shot! Bell with 30. Bell said, don't give it to him. They run it. The wheel play. They get it back to Troy Bell. Bell checks clock. The shot clock is off. Bell inside. Tough shot. Leader got it! Well, tied at 71. Troy Bell was looking to his right at the game clock. Checked it. Got in deep. He was in great position and hit that intermediate jump shot, which we've talked so much about.
You know, a lot of arenas, Dave, have shot clocks and time clocks up on the basket now. And he was looking around for it, and he had to look to his right. And with that jump shot, he was looking at first, I thought, to the right side. And then he floats to the basket and gets his shot off.
He's hit a bunch of those shots tonight. Off the dribble and pull up. He's got 33 points on 10 of 21 shooting from the field. A perfect 10 for 10 at the free throw line.
And does he ever know where to get
inside, outside, go to the wing. He has range as a shooter.
Here is Bell.
Oh, yes.
Hit his last two threes after the long streak was stopped earlier this half.
I'll tell you, he's got the Kobe look. He's got the Kobe look. But you can't have the cash register go ding-a-ling-ding.
Good steal by Bell. He took it away from Duhon. Williams doesn't give up, and Bell connects.
Bell with a good explosive move to the goal. Excellent open court player. He's going to be a good NBA player. But word is, going to see Bell right here come up with the steal. He strips him, and then he knows how to finish it off with that speed from out of Minnesota. Tries to make like a big wing back, tries to make Lechner very effective. Carlos Buzanel, take a look right here. A little too quick for Dunleavy in a one-on-one maneuver, and then hangs it and lays it with the left hand on the glass. And this is his game at his best. I mean, that's a little Kobe Bryant-ish. I mean, that's Kobe-ish. By Georgetown.
Nice take by Bell. Got it to go.
He's having a big time second half.
Sure. Troy now has a 22 after a six-point first half. Don't forget Steve Levy is in the building here tonight.
Yeah, Steve here.
The lead is 14. That's a Bell 2.
Troy Bell has really found his game.
One-on-one action with TJ Ford. This is the matchup we talked about.
Bell 0 for 2, and he takes it down. Harris on the wing. 10 on the shot clock, stolen by Bell. Bell chased by Williams, takes it up, and pulls the rim. Troy Bell with a couple of buckets now, 4 points.
William Texas far more athletic, far more determined on the offensive boards.
Thomas with 8, but Bell answers back with the 3, and quickly he has double figures. Weaving, left it out front for Thomas. Loose ball, Bell has it. Pull up jumper.
That is like a layup for him, or has been in his career. The good thing about that kind of shot, you pull up jump in the first half, that would have been a second and a third shot.
Bell launches. Oh, 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 watch out. 16 for offensively change for the Longhorns.
Absolutely. He put the clamps on Troy Bell, but not this time.
Bell is feeling it. 21, 11 in this half. A stoic look. Let some help come by. Bell dribble, drives, baseline, the floater. Ball. Erskine has it. Loose ball again on the deck. Bodies fly. It goes off. Bell has it. Up and in. Boy, Boston College will not die.
Meetings between UConn and Boston College. The Eagles 9-8, despite the presence of the leading and third leading scorers in the conference in their lineup. Troy Bell and Craig Smith between them average 44 points. Not only that, Bucky, but they have a third player who can light it up for 20 on any given night. Bell has scored 89 points in his last 3 games. Tries to beat Talik Brown off the dribble and does. Side. Turnover number 3 for the Huskies. More turnovers than attempts. And Bell knocks down the 3. And Jim Calhoun has seen enough. He calls time. And what do you say about those bad start? UConn's down 10.
A couple of those shots are not even in this area code. So it's hard to defend those. But Jim can make a case for the out hustle that the Huskies are seeing into the paint. Man, oh man, look at that. That is range. Big time.
Puts it on the floor in between the legs at 6'7", 265. Deep three by Bell. Oh. The Eagles have not won a game at UConn in 16 years. It's their first time playing here at Gamble. Made 27 of their first 33 shots last Wednesday. And there is Bell for another wide open 3.
Well, coming out.
Denham Brown makes the first one. Troy Bell has outscored UConn himself the first 13 and a half minutes. Last time these two teams. Troy Bell with 19 first half points.
The main man on fire, Bell. He wanted to go to Minnesota, but they said no.
He's away. And here's Boston College ahead of everyone is Bell. Tools. Bell with Robertson on him. Shoots the 3 right in Robertson's face.
Oh, he had his tonsils checked.
18th best rebounding team in the country. Troy Bell with 26 points. And his club is killing UConn.
We are loaded here with talent, happy guys. Now this guy, Smith, he's a freshman. What did you tell him about playing Connecticut, Troy?
I didn't tell him too much, man. Craig's definitely a player, best freshman in the country. I had to tell him too much.
And that's from Troy Bell, the defending Big East Player of the Year. There was a guy named Okafor on the floor today. Did you see or hear of him?
Huh? I mean, I seen him, but, you know, I don't know what happened. You know, we just shut him down.
Ryan Sidney, you always have a comment, and if you ever can be eloquent with the scoreboard 95 BC 71 UConn, today's the day.
Oh, yeah. Happy, extremely happy. We played great defense. We played together as a team, and that's all we could do. You know, everybody came out and contributed it on all ends of the floor, and I think that's what made our team that much better today.
Well, they say Eagles don't flock. They have to find them one at a time. I got three here that were super today. Bob?
Thank you very much, Bucky. Troy Bell with 26 points, Smith with 20, Ryan Sidney 17 and 8, Ben Gordon leading UConn with 15, Talik Brown with 12. UConn slips to 4-2 in the conference, BC 3-4 in the league. So for Bucky Waters, I'm Bob Picozzi. Thanks so much for joining us, and so long from Gamble Pavilion and Stores, where Boston...
Boy, BC, arguably one of the hottest teams, not only in the Big East, but the land right now. They've won 7 of the last 8, and they are being driven by the guy who will be the Big East Player of the Year, Troy Bell.
Well, certainly one of the hottest teams, one of the hottest players, not only in the conference, but in the country. Look at those numbers. Look at the field goal percentage, over 60%, and he has not only elevated his own numbers, he's elevated his teammates as well. He leads the team in steals, he's one of the leaders in assists, and he's getting help from that guy. Last week they did the double as Troy Bell wins the Big East Player of the Week. Craig Smith wins the Big East Rookie.
Guard both elbows. Good pressure here, and there's the guy who makes the steals.
Bell steals it. Bell lays it in.
Sweet left-hand move. He is the conference leader in steals. There's another one.
Telegraph that one. Bell, let's give him a quick 4 points.
A little dunkage there. Says, I'm only 6'1", but I can dunk it with both hands. Look at the great trap to get him at midcourt, a dangerous place. Then Troy finishes it. That's the beauty of it. You can't just get the steals. You got to finish. This is an easy finish. He's the only one in the picture. The other one was a sweet left-hand move and way too many turns. Got to like the guy's courage, but that has been a problem and not getting any better today turning the ball over.
And that's where Troy Bell usually does his
cast, and you're waiting for somebody to step up. You can't even get a shot. You get more than twice as many turnovers as points.
Troy Bell, another three ball. He has 10 points by himself, which is Miami.
Another look.
Bell.
Yep, that's deadly. And Perry Clark beside himself with good reason. You dodged the bullet once. The guy missed a simple little delivery. Watch, he gets the rebound, throws it up there where Sidney doesn't have to break stride, and Sidney does the rest. But if that ball's not delivered right where it is, Sidney loses that split second. Watch the little touch, like a quarterback. Lay it out there right for the receiver, and that gives him the angle to the goal. And the layup, a simple little thing, but the great players make their teammates better. And that's what he just did right there for Sidney. And get a wide open look.
Bell thinking shot all the way in, and it counts.
Well, that time the shot clock was down to 4. No time for ball reversal. That one made sense. If you're going to have somebody who has to make a go, give it to this guy. Look at Bell with the shake, the fake, and he does that better than anybody in America. Elevate on the jump shot and draw the foul. He'll do that from behind the three-point line. We talked about that. 60 times he's been fouled on a three-point shot, that time in the mid-range. So the dying art in basket. Trying to get three back. They make up 2 on the possession. Bell tries to answer.
Bell right back at you.
Oh, that's what the great ones do.
Oh, I'm Rob Stone. Boston College had a 14-point lead at the break, and Troy Bell has just upped it to 12. Miami had started off very well in the second half. Abarak and Troy Bell, 9 of 16 from the field, 6 three balls.
That's pretty impressive as you take a look overall. Miami shooting 52%. And that normally would spell trouble for Boston College. The only area statistically where Boston College shows a significant advantage night in and night out is shooting the ball. They shoot about 49% and only give up 40.
Stand for the Canes. Ring my bell. Troy with 35. He's
take a look at Bell. Just when you're 5 foot, barely, well, we'll be generous and say 6'1". I guess he's 6'1". I stood next to him before the game. We'll say 6'1". You've got to be able to...
Time, they kind of let Miami back into the game. Troy Bell and the rest of his mates respond.
Gee, for a little guy, you'd think he'd have a hard time putting a whole group of men on his shoulders and carrying them for weeks at a time, but doesn't seem to have weakened him any. He's still going strong.
He should be a first-round pick in the NBA draft.
Oh, and almost stole it.
They are now all alone in second place, and they're that close to wrapping up a bye in the first round of the Big East tournament.
And an NCAA bid, two tremendous objectives that a big step closer taken today by Boston College.
Boston College next up Saturday versus UConn.
Up 2-3 zone by St. John's to start. They've got to get to shooters. And with Troy Bell's skills, it just seems like he's been wearing that red uniform for a while. Bell for three. Troy Bell, 2 for 2. And there's nothing like getting off to a good start for a shooter. One is for Bell, a long three. And Troy Bell has drained a couple of threes. He has 8, and Boston College pushes the lead to 5. Way to score. And he goes inside a lot, not afraid to bring it in. Troy Bell in traffic, and he answers back. Anything you can do, I can do at least as well. Got a great matchup here with Bell and Hatton. We talked about it. Great runner by Bell. Hatton had made an acrobatic shot at the other end, slicing between two defenders. One of them on Ingram. Here's Bell off the screen, and he hits the three. He's a guy that can fill it up. He just needs to get it across the timeline. They do with Glover. And then he loses it to Bell. Glover fights back for it and throws it right to Bell. Quickly up court for Sidney. Drives and lays it in. That's a great job by BC. A couple of times that's happened. Both teams lose ball club during the half because you cannot allow St. John's second and third chances. Then Bell again. In it. Gets a step. Nice speed for Bell. Count it and the foul. Wow, the freshman Hinnett with a gorgeous feed to the senior Troy Bell. Ryan Sidney loves it, so do the BC fans. Critical right now. Bell gets a screen in the open three. Troy Bell gives Boston College the lead. What a great game.
Right now is that Boston College not being able to get the ball inside to their big guy Craig Smith has decided they got to go perimeter. And Troy Bell is the man you want to go to. Now, as far as the Irish are concerned, early
and on the shot clock, Troy Bell working against Torian Jones. Bell so tough on the perimeter, can get that shot away and gets it.
Oh. He's got the rhythm now.
You can tell by his emotion carry, and he doesn't play the game the way he's capable of playing.
Nice move by Troy Bell.
That was sweet, guys. He needs to let the game come to him.
Sidney with the left side to Bell, and Troy Bell, who was doing it from the outside of the first half, has gone for his first two baskets here in the second half. 6 unanswered points by the Eagles to start the second half, and Ryan Sidney, despite the 3 fouls, a big part of it. Largely because of the play of Ryan Sidney here in the second half so far.
Well, only 10 minutes in the first half, as you mentioned, because of foul trouble, but this guard tandem in Bell and Sidney, pretty good one themselves. We talk about Thomas and Carroll, but Sidney has really come out and tried to make the most of the time he's getting on the floor. And again, here, a little eye contact. These guys have been playing together for a long time. This is what makes Boston College tough. Those two guys, it begins there.
Well, speaking of tough, one of the Boston College games I did last year, if you take a look at Ryan, so good. Now Miller had it stripped away, and Bell has it again. He's got the speed. He's going to go all the way. And oh, that's going to be goaltending, I believe. Yes, and a foul. Bell is going to have an opportunity to give Boston College the lead.
Notre Dame has come out in this first half maybe under a false sense of comfort. And you're right. Boston College totally aggressive on the defensive end. You see what it leads to. You know, people talk about turnovers and you talk about steals. You know, turnovers don't mean nearly as much because a lot of them are dead ball type of situations where you can set your defense. When you look at steals, though, those are open floor opportunities, allowing teams to get out on a fast break. One more, at least, to give.
Well, that was in rhythm, and he hits it. Craig Smith went hard, and I mean hard, to the floor.
But for him, of course, he did set the record on the road, so he came home to accept the ball from his coach as the all-time leading scorer in school history. And that is quite a feat, Bucky.
Al Skinner, in his own humble, quiet way, gave it up. Got out of the way.
He surpassed the record of Dana Barros with Billy Curley. Kanye Abrams not far behind. Miami went on a bit of a run. Bell for three. Banks it in and it counts. Wow.
Well, he's warming up. He just had 3 free throws. Now he hits a 3 and gets another one. I like the way he counts.
Oh, and there's a little divot. There's a little divot in that glass in the square. But he's so smart. Once he knew he got hit, he made sure that it wasn't going to be short, which is often the problem when you're...
Eagles, Miami staying in it. Bell with a three. Yeah. And that's his second. So Troy Bell already in double... Now Bell quickly with another three, and that's right. Miami's still shooting 50%, but the Eagles still over 60%. And you talk about a three-pointer, you might get 3.5 or 4.
Simmons only shooting 25%. Here goes that pass down inside. Look at the body control and deceptive strength of Troy Bell. He loves to take it into you so he can get to that free throw line and get some.
Either look for that or maybe an explosion by Troy Bell, where they can't open it up to double figures. And there's part of that explosion right there. Troy Bell has 24 points, 5.
Bell.
Dornikamp is outside with Rice. Bell all alone for another three. No problem. That's his sixth, 27 points. So he's got half the total. You've got a good shooter, you got to get him open, get him the ball, right?
Paolo Coelho, watch number two, Troy Bell, just keep rubbing Coelho off, using his own man and using his teammates to get free. Unbelievable. He is 6 for 9 from three, a very efficient 8 for 11 from the floor, a masterful piece of offensive maneuvering. He never forces. He uses his screens well. What a terrific player.
It's been terrific. There it is. It's been about that 55% most of the afternoon. Miami. Not much in three-point shooting, but Troy Bell.
Quick three for Troy Bell, and he drains it.
For most players, you say not high percentage, but Troy Bell, so smooth, reads the defense, and he's really been in a great shooter's role.
Two for Bell. Twisting layup, and Troy Bell now with 5 in the ball game. And Boston College, here's Troy Bell. Bell for 3 in the record. Got it! Troy Bell with a 3 has become Boston College's all-time leading scorer. He passes Dana Barros.
And what a win.
Bell needed 7 to pass Dana Barros, and to break the record, he gets 8.
Check it out. He is way beyond the 19-foot-9-inch three-point line. See Tim Higgins. He's got the hand up. This is a 3, no doubt about it. McGrath in the neighborhood. Forget about it. The record holder, the alt.
Bell sets for 3. Troy Bell wide open. And Boston College regains the lead.
So they'll need him to get going. He was quiet against Rutgers over the weekend. And check Bell out.
Bell hits the 3 and he's fouled. That is now the 56th time in his career he's fouled taking a 3. And in his career, that is the 9th time that he's hit the field goal while attempting a 3. He's made 7 out of 8 free throws in that situation.
I mean, you just don't want to foul a jump shooter. Forget about
Sidney for Bell. Passes up the 3, takes the baseliner. It's good, and the foul for Bell. The most prolific scorer in Boston College history adds to his totals.
He's quick. You know he can shoot the 3. Shea Kukaba not happy. He says not a team with guys like Bell to turn it over a lot.
Look at the first step by Bell and Molina. Left it short. Bell to follow with the left hand. And he has
Shea Kukaba will check into the game to replace, I'm sure, Halitz. Troy Bell has got that quick release. I mean, how many times are we going to see him get fouled on jump shots? Not a good idea, and he's able to make it with his concentration. Things down too early. There's still quite a bit of time left.
Bell for 3. Troy Bell. Oh. Ringing the bell. He's got 33.
Take the game over. Troy Bell showing you why. This is a clinic.
Troy Bell with 33 points. 9 of 18 from the floor. 5-11 from three-point range. 10 of 11 from the line. Boston College's all-time leading scorer, putting on yet another clinic, which he seems to do every night out.
He's got a great release. It's a quick release. He freezes the defense. You can tell he feels it. So poised. And he just does it. I mean, 20-plus points, game 64 times in his career, over 30, 12. Here he is tonight, and double figures in 106 out of 112. That's the consistency factor, and that's what makes him the all-time leading scorer at Boston College.
Boy, he loves playing against Providence. This is his seventh career game against the Friars. He's shooting it at just over 50%. Coming in, averaging 23 a game against Providence, and obviously with 33 tonight, that number goes up.
Conference with a huge game next tomorrow against Notre Dame at South Bend.
Troy Bell knocking one back from long range again. Doesn't take too much time. You give him a split second, and he will deliver.
And all of a sudden, Jim, he is up to an 8-point production. Here is Bell with a steal. He's got Jermaine Watson. And he drives to the basket as an unselfish Troy Bell gives Boston College. Who I was. Here is Bell, and he fires and strikes. And Troy Bell with a beautiful long-range shot. He's up to 13 points, and BC extends to a 6-point lead.
You know, one of the things they have to be concerned supposed to happen for Boston College. You see the little slip cut, a little floater to the basket, nice little drive. And then he goes long range to knock one back from the corner. A little pull up off the dribble. Well, what can he do? I mean, defensively, drives to the hoop, nice little dish in the finish. You know,
BC,
Troy Bell has really been involved, and it's just fun to watch, especially if you're sitting up here.
It is fun to watch, particularly for Coach Al Skinner, as BC's now made it.
And up on a shot. Your body language is totally different shooting the basketball.
Freshman Calvin Wooten has scored 11 so far for Rutgers, but right back the other way.
Cut.
Bell fires. Talk about creating your own shot. He didn't have any room there and still knocked it down.
Quick.
For the Naismith National Player of the Year Award, and he leads the Big East in steals. Back with the starting lineups at opening tip.
Abbott knocks it away. Sydney gets it back. Now Bell, right side pull up.
Yeah, I mean, eventually those three guys are going to score. I don't think there's ever been a question about that.
It has Hinnon on the right. Instead, hits Bell with a tough pass. Counted in the foul.
Yeah, Troy Bell gets to the free throw line about 8 times a game. He gets fouled more than any other player I've ever seen from behind the arc, but he can also attack the rim. We have a near turnover by Watson, might have gotten away with it. And then the bump, the initiate by Bell.
He throws each time when you knock him down like he does at over 80%.
Wow, and he was out there a bit on that one.
Didn't get fouled that time.
Forget about the discussion of moving the line back. He's gone anyway, but it wouldn't matter.
Down by Smith, his third. And all alone is Bell, and with that basket, Bell has now hit double figures for the 100th time in his career. And Jay Wright wants time.
It's a little different when you're causing turnovers and getting into the ice. Troy Bell, end-to-end speed is exceptional. His ups aren't bad either. Tough to stop that.
He mentioned seventh in the country in field goal shooting. He's the 17th leading scorer in the country. When you think of Bell, the word consistency probably sums it up more than anything.
Well, I think it's remarkable that he scored as many as he did last season, up over 21 points per game. Remember that he had the knee surgery.
Right. It's a dream job. Philadelphia born and reared. Bell on the left, hits the jump shot.
That's one way to create a shot against the longer 6'7 Sumter. Back him off with a little crossover dribble and then step back. Create space two ways. Use the dribble to gather yourself, get power.
Bell for three.
Got it. Boy, he's taking a couple of quick looks. One he makes, one he misses.
Sullivan didn't score Saturday at Rutgers. I think his teammates teased him about that. They scored 110. He didn't get anything. Bell showing why he leads the conference in steals.
Yeah, he's got great anticipation and end-to-end speed. I mean, he turns it from defense to offense in a hurry.
With 24 points, the 100th double-figure scoring effort of his magnificent career.
draft on ESPN, Troy Bell's going to have a sick feeling in his stomach. Unlike LeBron James, Bell isn't sure he'll hear his name. So BC's all-time leading scorer was in Chicago the first week of June for the pre-draft camp. A strong showing could launch Bell into the first round and guaranteed money. A poor effort would crush his hopes. Here's Dan Patrick.
A lot of people dodge things like this and dodge workouts, but that's never been my style. You know, if anybody wants to see me play, I'm ready to play. I mean, this is all the pressure, and you just got to put out. Put out, or you're going to get left behind. I got some hash browns, some eggs, and that fruit, and that was $16. It's crazy. I'm glad they gave us that per diem. I've heard everything from like mid-first to mid-second, so I guess it just depends on who's writing and who likes me and who likes everybody else. But I mean, that's why I'm at this camp right now, just trying to clear up any questions guys had about me.
In his first game in front of the NBA coaching fraternity, Bell scores a game-high 17 points and dishes out 7 assists as his team storms back to win.
Hey, Troy's the point, so. You know, he gets the ball in his hand. He didn't have to pass it if he doesn't want it.
I don't have to, but I always give it to you.
I'm always waiting, being like, hey, Troy. He looks my way, shoots it every time.
Sign that for me?
No problem.
After signing a few autographs and answering a few questions.
Any kind of constructive criticism someone's willing to offer me is something I'll definitely work with.
Bell retires to his room to watch some of the players he hopes will be his colleagues.
San Antonio was doing it tonight. I just want to watch the TV or be at the draft and just see a number pop up so I can just go get my E500 Mercedes. That's all I want to do. Can I just get a car?
Just get ready to go do my thing again. No pressure, no worries. Go out there, have a little fun.
Bell's second game is much like his first. He leads his team in scoring on the way to another victory.
Overall, I give myself a B again. I think I had a couple turnovers today that were unforced. I think they were because I wasn't as aggressive as I should have been.
Bell's team suffers its only loss in the Friday morning game, but again, he leads his team in scoring. A rigorous afternoon awaits.
Getting ready to go do the strength testing over at the gym, the vertical, bench, and all that. That's about it. Hopefully I can finish this off well.
Bell excels in the physical testing, impressing the coaches and scouts with his vertical jump.
11-6 and a half.
Speed.
That's good.
And agility.
You got it.
But he comes up a little short of his goal of 20 reps with 185 pounds, managing just 17 reps.
So we can't bounce it off our chest at all, so. A little harder, but 17 was okay, and I did all right on the other drill, so I guess I'm satisfied with it.
This is my favorite part of the week because I don't have to play any more games, I don't have to do any more drills until I get to my individual workouts in like a couple days, but this right here, just chilling, knowing I'm done, and I played pretty well, and I have my donuts, and I have my cinnamon rolls, and I mean, everything's good right now.
He was a Minnesota high school phenom, and now he's in the NBA, and he'd be the first to tell you he couldn't have done it without his mom and dad.
Former Holy Angels star Troy Bell recently made his NBA debut with the Memphis Grizzlies.
And you can be sure the two proudest people in that arena that night were Troy's parents, Fred and Maggie Bell. In tonight's Extra, a story that might change the way you think about millionaire athletes. Well, at least this one anyway. Carol Evans' Boyd Hubert has spent months with the Bell family and shows us a side of Troy you won't see on any basketball court.
You'd expect Memphis to be rocking for the Grizzlies season opener on Halloween.
Let's go, Grizzlies!
Wouldn't even be surprised to hear some high hopes.
Good jumper.
For the Grizzlies' top draft pick.
The shooter.
Troy Bell.
This is Troy Card, right here.
He's got all kind of potential.
But how unlikely to find the newest pocket of Grizzlies fans on Twin Cities Metro Transit Route. Number 9.
It's really been fun to follow Troy and what he's accomplished.
Hey, how you doing?
The downtown office workers who ride Route 9 and followed Troy through the stories of a blue-collar dad.
I think Troy's gonna really like it there.
He's so humble about it. Fred is.
Well, good morning. How are you?
As for the story you're watching right now, sorry if you tuned in to see basketball.
38th Street.
This is a story about parenting.
Hey, Mom, they got any more baked beans?
And what we all can learn from Fred and Maggie Bell.
I'm doing my job.
The sports world came calling at the Bell's Clinton Avenue home on NBA draft night back in June.
You can just write it right up on the state champs there.
All right.
Troy, who went from all-time leading scorer for Holy Angels High School to all-time leading scorer for Boston College,
backdoor Bell, 24,
was nearly certain to be drafted in the first round.
But if you challenge him, this is what Troy Bell can do to you as well.
That's pretty cool.
But that wasn't what made Maggie the proudest.
This is great having all you guys here, but, you know, I've already got my present. May 19th, when you graduated from Boston College.
Look at Lily was here.
The only child of Fred and Maggie Bell got his upbringing in a neighborhood that hasn't always been kind to kids.
It takes the parents to have a vision, and then I think the child kind of started living that same vision you had.
Come on, Troy, let's do it.
Gymnastics, karate, track, wrestling, baseball, football, basketball, and the drums.
I got a trumpet up there under his bed.
Fred and Maggie throw water on the newly popular notion that kids are overscheduled these days.
You expose them to whatever they think they want to try. If you can afford it, let them try it. If they quit it, let them quit it. They're going to find something they like.
While Fred drove bus, Maggie worked for State Farm Insurance.
You got to take care of your baby.
Take it.
Earning the extra money they needed to pay for Troy's activities and Catholic schools.
He met the teachers, knew the principals, we knew everybody in the schools, so he couldn't get away with nothing.
They took the time to know the other kids in their neighborhood, too. Week after week, packing both their cars with every boy on the football team who didn't have a ride to practice.
You're thinking the car stop ain't gonna take everybody, Jeff, because there's too many kids in one car.
We'll grab a plate.
The same way they packed their house with family and friends.
What's up, boy?
The night Troy became the 16th pick.
Troy Bell.
In the 2003 NBA draft. Troy would sign with the Memphis Grizzlies for more than $3.5 million. But on his first trip back to Minneapolis, there was never a question who'd still be mowing the lawn.
I always got to it.
And who'd make him do it again if he didn't get it right.
You wouldn't hire him. It was your lawn. For free, we can accept this.
Clearly, things had changed when Troy put his new Mercedes in the driveway.
Yeah, it's fun, man.
And his old Beretta in the street.
He got one of those little sun things.
But how couldn't his parents be pleased when Troy used his new car to give a neighborhood kid a lift?
We went to Southdale Mall, and he bought me some shoes.
He's still a nice kid, you know, and that's the biggest compliment I can give Troy. He's still a nice person.
Put another way, Troy Bell climbed the ladder to the NBA.
I love this room.
And didn't forget who he came from.
And I'm blessed to have the parents that I had. Definitely.
So Friday night, when the Grizzlies opened their season in Memphis, where do you think Fred and Maggie were?
I saw that.
Oh, yeah, we weren't going to miss this for nothing.
They were joined by Troy's aunt, two uncles, and his 81-year-old grandpa, who flew all the way from Superior, Wisconsin, to watch Troy play.
Three, count it.
Only Troy didn't.
He's never stood on the bench before. This is the first time for that.
With a close game and no starters in foul trouble, the rookie spent the evening like any other spectator, just a better seat.
Oh, no!
The Grizzlies lost by a basket, and Troy had to hustle to catch a team plane. Not the Disney ending we'd hoped for when we traveled to Memphis with Fred and Maggie, but maybe the ending most fitting.
I'll see you guys when I get back.
For Maggie and Fred didn't become great parents by just being there to share the glory. So much as by just being there.
He'll be fine. It'll come out where he'll get his chance. He'll prove himself.
Boyd Hooper, KARE 11 News, Memphis.
Grizzlies president Jerry West told us Troy's personality and upbringing played an important role in his decision to pursue Troy in the draft. If you'd like to hear excerpts of our interview with West and also with Troy's fifth grade coach, just go to care11.com and click on Feature.